When it comes to electric vehicles, this channel tends to focus on ones that you can either own or borrow. But today I'm going to talk to you about another type of electric vehicle that has the potential to make a far bigger impact on the world than any number of fancy electric cars. What's more, I'm going to tell you why you should be excited that they're coming to a city near you very soon. I am, of course, talking about electric buses, the big brothers of the electric car, which, until about a decade ago, were relatively unheard of. And while, yes, history is dotted with examples of electric bus pilot projects dating way back into the middle of last century, I even had an experimental electric bus from the late 90s sitting on my driveway in England for a few months, waiting to be fixed, electric buses have traditionally been held up by unreliable battery technology, which made it impossible for buses to have any kind of reasonable range and reliability. But now, thanks to the advent of high-capacity lithium-ion batteries and the incredible improvements made in battery energy density and battery power density over the past few years, electric buses are becoming mainstream. In fact, companies like Proterra, Volvo and BYD are bringing about a change that could save cities hundreds of thousands of dollars in fuel costs alone, reduce pollution and improve city life. You see, for many years, diesel has remained the fuel choice of many bus fleets around the world. Diesel engines are robust, can put up with high mileages asked of them, can operate in a variety of different weather types, and have plenty of torque for lugging around busloads of people on busy commuter routes. But diesel engines are anything but clean. Nitrogen oxides, particulates, and hydrocarbons are all emitted by the tailpipe of your average diesel bus. And while an EPA study back in 2012 concluded a brand new 2012 model year diesel bus emitted 94% less nitrogen oxides, 98% less particulates, and 89% less hydrocarbons than a 2000 model year bus, they still play a massive factor in contributing to poor air quality in large cities like London, New York, and Paris. And while some cities have diversified their fleets in recent years, experimenting with compressed natural gas, hybrid drivetrains, and yes, even methane made from biodegrading human waste, these vehicles haven't proven popular for a variety of reasons, ranging from more complex drivetrains and onboard systems to special fueling requirements, or in the case of those buses fueled by chip shop waste in the UK, a pungent odour which was either a love it or a loathe it thing. Electric buses, now they're technically capable of carrying out their daily duties without requiring massive downtime to recharge during the day, offer none of the tailpipe emissions of conventional buses, yet have plenty of low-end torque to carry large numbers of passengers around town, are generally quicker accelerating than diesel buses, and do not waste energy when sitting in traffic. And while they still cost a pretty penny, about $200,000 to $300,000 more than diesel buses, they can still represent large savings over the lifetime of the bus. Why? Well, electricity is a lot cheaper than diesel to buy, and just like electric cars, electric buses have far less moving parts than an internal combustion engine model, meaning less to go wrong mechanically and consequently less money spent servicing them over the lifetime of the vehicle. Yes, there are some initial outlay costs associated with a fleet switchover, such as training mechanics on electric bus systems and installing charging systems at the bus depot and or on routes. But once those initial capital expenditures have been taken care of, running costs for electric buses are remarkably low. Moreover, unlike your average private car buyer, it's pretty easy to make the business case for an electric bus when you're looking at amortizing the cost over the hundreds of thousands of miles that your average bus will do in its lifetime. Of course, capital expenditures associated with going electric have to be taken care of. But here's the neat thing. Many countries, like the US, for example, heavily subsidize public transit systems, meaning not only local taxpayer money helps fund the transit system, but national government chips in too, with grants and assistance packages designed to get fleets modernized. And before you moan about government throwing money away, remember that removing older, heavily polluting diesel buses from the roads is in the best interests of the actual cities and the country that those cities are in, because lost earnings due to sick days soon adds up. As the famous Six Cities study, I'll link to it below, proved way back in 1993, people who live in cities with high levels of PM2.5 concentrations, including diesel particulate emissions, experience as much as 2 or 3 years shorter life expectancy than those who live in cities with low levels of PM2.5, which means that removing diesel buses and replacing them with electric buses can reduce premature deaths caused by pollution, improve overall health, and in result, less lost earnings due to sickness caused by poor air quality. I should, of course, acknowledge here that just like electric cars, electric buses are only as clean as the energy used to power them. But just as many city fleets are looking to clean up their transit systems, so too are local utilities working hard to improve their renewable energies on their energy mix portfolios. And unlike regular buses, which get more polluting as their engines get more and more tired, electric buses get cleaner as the grid gets cleaner. Drivers like them too, as they're smooth and responsive to drive, and so too do the passengers. So say goodbye to a diesel bus and prepare to embrace electric buses in your city. The only challenge to all those buses? Picking a recharging standard that works for everyone, because there are different ones, although that's the same for cars, right? That's it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell to hear the moment a new show is uploaded. And click the Patreon link at the end of this video or in the description below if you want to help me make more of these videos. Until next time, keep evolving.